Harper Design and Harper Audio present Health Revolution, Finding Happiness and Health Through an Anti-Inflammatory Lifestyle by Maria Borelius, translated by Sonia Wichman, read by Jane Oppenheimer. A note before we begin. Don't forget to download the accompanying enhancement PDF from your audiobook provider, or go directly to www.harpercollins.com/audio/health-revolution. It contains helpful lists, recipes, and more, and will be referred to as the enhancement. We shall not cease from exploration, and the end of all our exploring will be to arrive where we started and know the place for the first time. T.S. Eliot. This is a book about my journey. At the age of 52, I was experiencing menopause symptoms, back pain, fatigue, and a general feeling of melancholy about my life. I felt that everything was beginning to go downhill. But after just a few months with a new lifestyle, my life had changed. I was happier, stronger, and pain-free. What had happened? Through a series of remarkable coincidences, I realized that I had stumbled on something completely new, anti-inflammatory food that could cure and prevent illness and even mysteriously put the brakes on aging. That's how my journey of knowledge began, a journey during which, filled with wonder, I began to research this new landscape and discovered that it encompassed much more than diet. The contours of a whole new lifestyle emerged, and the clues came to me from many different people, each one amazing in his or her own way. I encountered, among others, an innovative and inspiring fitness model in Canada, a professor in Lund, Sweden, working at the very forefront of research, an Indian health spa with a punishing enema treatment, a prehistoric hominid in Addis Ababa by the name of Lucy, one of London's most visionary dermatologists, unusually long-lived members of a religious sect in the outskirts of Los Angeles, a Danish TV celebrity who turned out to be 15 years older than I thought, a gut group in the English countryside, a top geneticist at Karolinska Institutet, Sweden, with a weakness for riddles, a hip-swinging yoga instructor at a New Age meeting in California, and an ethereal detective searching for human wonder. Each one of them has played a role in this drama. And so has my own experimentation. I have poked around among omega-3 fatty acids, probiotics, gluten, lactose, meditation, bone broth, Ayurvedic nose diagnosis, HIIT training, yoga, sunsets, inflammation markers, and spirituality apps. I have set out filled with curiosity, but have often encountered failures and had to find a different path. Step by step, I felt my way forward as I worked to solve the puzzle of how low-degree systemic inflammation causes illness and what we can do to make ourselves stronger, happier, and healthier. All of this has resulted in a 5-point program to bring out the best version of all of us. A program that combines everything I've learned with a conviction that a lifestyle has to work on the practical level, in everyday life, and in our lives together with other people. There's a health revolution happening right now, where a whole new way of thinking about food, exercise, rest, awe, and health is being constructed. And through this process, we are discovering new tools for living in a lighter and stronger way. This is my story, and I'm sharing it with you in the hope that you will find inspiration, healing, and your path to empowerment. Maria Borelius, London, November 2017. The unexamined life is not worth living. Socrates. 1. A New Year. It's a new year, 2013. I'm 52 years old, and I'm feeling puffy and washed out. Christmas has brought way too much of everything: pickled herring, gingerbread, cheese sandwiches on raisin-studded Christmas bread, schnapps, toffee, and boxes of chocolates devoured at lightning speed. And on the heels of this holiday excess came a New Year's trip to the shores of Kenya, with cocktails at sunset and three-course dinners with wine in the velvety African night. The trip back takes 24 hours. When we get home and I have to carry my bag upstairs, I feel like I'm 80 years old, even though I've just spent a week in the sun. There's a dull ache in my lower back, and my joints hurt. I'm in the throes of perimenopause, and my period shows up fitfully, on its own schedule. My feet are sore and swollen. And then there's my belly, or my muffin top, as the women's magazines like to call it, a jiggling roll that desperately wants to spill out over the waistband of my jeans. These days, every visit to a clothing store ends the same way. After admiring all the figure-hugging pieces, I'm drawn like a magnet to long tops that cover and disguise. I also have constant little infections and keep coming down with colds and sore throats. An ongoing low-grade urinary tract infection has led to repeated courses of antibiotics, which make me feel tired and a little sick. This is what it's like to start aging. Oh, I guess there's only one direction to go now, and that's downhill. So thinks a melancholic part of me. Another part of me snorts, "Don't be so pretentious. Be happy you're alive. You have healthy children and can work. Get on with life." Fair enough. But a third side of me is looking for something more. It's part of human nature to want to improve yourself. You don't always have to accept the cards that life deals you. We want to shape our own destiny. The questions burn in me because it's more than just my back, my belly, and my infections. Whatever happened to that strong and happy younger woman? She may still be strong and happy, but there are longer stretches between the bright days. More and more often, I wake up feeling melancholy, or blue, as people say. I feel blue all over, or gray. I regret all the things that I didn't have time to do with the children when they were younger. I grieve for my dead father and brother, and for my mother who is ill. I become annoyed more easily when I run into problems at work, and I see obstacles as personal defeats instead of seeing them as challenges that can be solved with creativity and willpower, the way I would have done in the past. I make a mental checklist. How is that life balance going? My eating habits are okay, I think. After the binge-eating lifestyle of my teenage years, my eating habits have gradually become normal. I eat what I feel like eating, which mostly means home cooking with lots of vegetables and olive oil. When I feel like baking a chocolate cake or mixing vanilla ice cream with pralines and caramel sauce, I do it without reflecting too much about it. On a hungry evening, I can easily put away 3 pieces of toast with plenty of butter, cheese, and orange marmalade, and then feel vaguely guilty. I don't know exactly why. But my everyday food doesn't feel extreme by any means. I love tea, which I drink in large quantities, just like my mother and my English grandmother. But I've cut back on coffee because it gives me headaches and makes me feel edgy and then tired. I like exercising, but it's a journey without any compass. I'll find a few newspaper articles about a new kind of exercise program and follow it for a week or two. I do a little jogging when I have time and the weather allows it. Light weightlifting at the gym a few times a week. A little swimming, a yoga class. Everything's possible, but nothing has any real shape except for the walks with our beloved dog Luna. I meditate, and I can still remember my own mantra. All in all, I'm not a wreck. Still, it's as if gravity is pulling me downward. Life is weighing down my whole being. I have an appointment with my gynecologist. I think I'm a little depressed, I tell him. No, you're going through menopause, he answers. Is all of this just to be expected? Should I simply resign myself? That's not in my nature. Buddha supposedly said, when the pupil is ready, the master will appear. In the Bible, Jesus says the same thing, seek and ye shall find. The idea that you can learn new things by setting out on a journey to find insight and knowledge is part of our spiritual tradition. So, that's exactly what I do. On a business trip to the United States, I happened to see a book on display in an airport bookstore. It has a typically American title, Your Best Body Now. Look and feel fabulous at any age, the Eat Clean Way. The woman who graces the cover is not a 25-year-old model, but a woman my age, who is glowing with health. She seems to welcome me. Her name is Tosca Reno, and she writes about her journey toward better health in an intelligent and convincing way. She describes how, in her 40s, as an overweight and depressed housewife who would binge on ice cream and peanut butter at night, she managed to escape her depressive lifestyle and embark on a journey of personal health. I can relate completely to the part about ice cream and peanut butter. I begin following her blog. Tosca makes smoothies, does weight training exercises, and eats lots of protein. But suddenly one day the content of the blog changes, from pleasant tips about healthy living to grave tragedy. Tosca's husband has lung cancer, and only a few days left to live. Part of me feels ashamed for following an American health blogger's story of her husband's death struggle, complete with pictures from his deathbed. They show the dying man greeting Arnold Schwarzenegger, apparently an old friend of his. Good for both of them, but it's embarrassing that I'm sitting here reading all this. In spite of that, I'm hooked. Toscarino writes about her husband's final hours in an open and sincere way that invites her readers in. After his death and funeral, she finds a personal trainer who is going to help her move past her grief. This trainer is a blonde Canadian by the name of Rita Catalino. The two of them begin training for some kind of competition in which Tosca is planning to participate in memory of her dead husband. What is this? I think to myself. But at the same time, who am I to judge someone who has just lost a loved one? Tosca and her personal trainer, Rita Catalino, start blogging together about health, work, love, and their inner life. When the trainer writes, it sparks something in me. This is about more than just lifting weights or running. This is about inner light. Around this time, along with two other women, I've decided to start an aid organization that will support vulnerable immigrant women by helping them to start small businesses. We plan to empower them through education, moral support, and microloans, so that they can realize their dreams of having work and income of their own. We're going to call it the Esther Foundation, and we've been preparing the launch for 2 years. Now it's about to happen. But the work is nonprofit, and I have to squeeze it in between my regular work as an entrepreneur and journalist and my family responsibilities. The paradox I'm facing is this. I will need more energy, but I have less. I think of the airline flight attendants and their oxygen masks. What is it they always say before the plane takes off? Put on your own oxygen mask first before assisting others. I'm forced to lift myself up, energize myself somehow in order to be able to give to others and to carry out this project that I am passionate about. And the situation is urgent. I suddenly have an idea. I'll seek out this Rita Catalino and ask her if she could train me too, online, across the Atlantic. I soon realize that Rita Catalino is a kind of fitness star in a world that's foreign to me, where she trains women who participate in American bodybuilding and fitness competitions. Way out of my league, in other words. So I write her an email. Dear Rita Catalino, I'm writing to you from across the Atlantic. I'm far from being an American fitness star. In fact, I'm a 52-year-old woman with 4 children and a heavy workload. In addition to my work, I'm about to start up an aid organization to support marginalized immigrant women. But if I'm going to have the energy to support others, I need to be strong myself. That's why I need your help. I'm flabby, I have backaches, and I'm going through perimenopause. But I'm dreaming of something else. I need a plan. Can you help me? Best regards, Maria B. Click. Very quickly, I get a reply. She asks me to answer a number of questions and send pictures of myself in my underwear.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.